In this video, I review the three things I see developers constantly doing that inhibit them from further success. We've all been there before, as you see, and it's extremely frustrating. So stay tuned with me till the end, and I'll tell you about how I made these exact same mistakes earlier in my career and what you can do to avoid them. Subscribe and hit the notification bell if you want more content like this in the future. And comment down below if you've made any of these mistakes or you felt I've missed a mistake that you see other developers making. My name is Jason Humphrey. I'm the founder of Coding Career Fastlane, where we help accelerate your coding career wherever you're at in the process. The first thing I see that really inhibits developers from more success is comparing. Comparing themselves against other people, other situations, other technologies, other code. Now, why is that? Well, I want to tell you a story about myself earlier in my career, and we'll go from there. When I started out, I honestly was not a very good developer. If you've heard my story before, I took remedial Java twice at my job, which is weird to say in itself. One of my biggest problems with this is I started comparing myself to other developers, whether they were around me, whether they were on the internet, whether they were people I went to school with. I was comparing myself to others, and it really got me down all the time of like, I can never be a great developer, I'll never get there. This is where I made the crucial mistake, because whatever you do next is never good enough, and whatever you did better than that person, well, now you compare to that person and you still don't compare, and so you never get to somewhere that is good enough, and so you always feel this way if you keep comparing. And this is generally where I found that the imposter syndrome really started creeping in for me, and that really, I wouldn't say hindered my career, but hindered my ability at achieving a lot of success earlier in my career. So what can you do about it? Well, you can start by making a list of what your strengths and weaknesses are, because generally your weaknesses are where you're comparing yourself to other people. But we also want to know our strengths so that it's not all about what we can't do, it's also about what we can do. But ideally we make a plan on our weaknesses, about what we want to get better at and how, with actionable dates, and I'll talk more about plans here in a little bit. Now, inevitably, you will compare yourself again to somebody else, to some other situation, some other technology. What you do next is crucial. Take what you're comparing against yourself with and write it down your list to make sure you get better at in the future, and put a due date on it so it's not just an arbitrary thing on a list that you never get around to. Now, maybe a list just isn't enough for you. And here's something else I did that I follow to this day. I've got a whole list of rules that I follow. I put up a couple videos on it. And so what you can do is make two rules here. Take either one of these you want, but I encourage making these two rules in your life. They'll make a huge impact. The first is, if you compare, then you dare. Now, I get that's a funny way to say it, right? Because it could totally be misconstrued, but I'm serious. Dare yourself to learn something that you've compared yourself against. It's a great little rule that I've followed for years on if I need to check myself at the door, that is a great way how. The second rule here is comparing praise, and it's as straightforward as it sounds. If you find yourself comparing yourself to someone, you give them praise for what they're doing. Even if it's the smallest thing, you find a way to praise them for it, because we want to try to break the habit of comparing as best as we can. Learning is something all developers should do constantly, and you should never stop learning. And yet earlier in my career, I found myself at a stagnated point where I wasn't learning, and I thought I knew everything. I thought I knew everything I needed to be a great developer. I thought I knew what it took to be at the next level. I thought I was owed things. I thought I was entitled to promotions, and I thought a lot of things, and it's really interesting how it all stems back to I had stopped learning because I thought I knew it all. And when I had stopped learning, I stopped providing a lot of value because my information, my knowledge was stagnant. I knew how to do one thing and one thing really well. And well, that is one problem I see where a lot of developers will stop learning and become content with where they're at, and myself included. Now, why does this happen? Because potentially you became really good at something and you learned a lot to get there. Sometimes we think that's enough, and then we kind of forget what it took to actually get to the mountaintop, how much work you actually had to put in, And now that you're taking it easy, it's like, oh, this is easy to continue. I'm at the top of my niche and I haven't had to do anything in a couple of years. And well, you become stagnant and you're gonna fall behind. And that's the biggest problem here, is you're now falling behind. So what can we do about this? First off, you can make a plan. And I know I've been harping on plans already in this video, but I'm serious when I say putting a plan and implementing it with due dates is absolutely crucial to be successful. But let's give some actionable items. What can you do? You can set time intervals to make sure you are learning and staying current and not falling behind. How do you do this? Well, for one, you can go to all the conferences. Now, I say all the conferences, but like, for example, the main Angular conferences are generally 1 to 2 times a year. That's a good time interval. Something else you can do is take one course every quarter. That's another good one. You can also go to meetups that are teaching one new topic a month. And last but not least, one of my favorite, you can set up time with a mentor 1 to 2 times a month to make sure that you are working with them on learning something new in your career. Now, something else I found that I was doing earlier in my career, and still it comes back to this day, is procrastination. I found that I was procrastinating a lot, especially at certain intervals where I was extremely afraid of not being good enough, or that I wasn't worthy enough, or that my code wasn't good enough for production. And I found that procrastination was really a defense mechanism to protect myself against not failing or not feeling the failure or the pain of whatever was in front of me was going to cause. And so why do we procrastinate? There's a lot of different reasons, but I'm going to talk about three now. The fear of failure, potentially at your job, at your code, at your life, whatever it might be. That fear is one of the biggest things that will drive us to procrastination. The second is being overwhelmed and overloading your mental capacity with too many things at one time. There's lots of different ways overwhelming yourself will manifest, but this is a really strong reason why procrastination will set in. And last but not least, bored. You haven't been challenged in a long time and the things you're doing are way too easy. What can we do about this? And I think you already know what's about to come, and that is setting a plan. Well, let's talk more in depth about what can you do in this specific plan. And there's two things in this plan, and that is take your tasks and set obtainable goals or due dates for them, and make sure you have listed out everything you need to know and there are no blockers, so that all you have to do is work. And at the same time, with these tasks, to make sure you're not overwhelmed, make sure you break them down. So if you follow the Fibonacci series for giving points on stories, make sure you aren't going anything over a 8 to 13 and that you're breaking any of those things down to be smaller. That way you don't get overwhelmed. And those due dates will really help you stay on track. The second thing I'm gonna say is to journal. And I get that's one that people all the time go like, journal, what do you mean? And I'm serious when I say this, because if you can't truly understand what you're thinking or feeling or understand where you're coming from, it's really hard to sniff out procrastination until it's too late. And procrastination will show itself because you'll have the fears, you'll have the overwhelmness, you'll have the boredom, you'll have all these things start showing up when you start thinking about it in a journal perspective. And that can ultimately help you not procrastinate. If you like today's content, give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe and notification bell so that you can get more content like this in the future. If you want help with some of the mistakes you're making in your own development career, then go ahead and schedule some time down below with the 30-minute free sessions I've set up. I've opened up 5 slots per week. They fill up pretty quickly, so if you're interested, go ahead and book now before they're gone. Overall, in this video, what are the takeaways? First, stop comparing yourself. Second, never stop learning. 3, stop procrastinating. Those are the 3 mistakes I see developers doing that inhibit further success for them in their own careers.